have hot gas coming out of the compressor, okay, going into our discharge line. This is going to be the hottest part of the system. Okay, once we come to our condenser, okay, we're removing heat from the system at this point. As it's coming out of the condenser, we now become a liquid. We go into our liquid line. From the liquid line, we go to our filter dryer, which is used to remove moisture from the system. At this point, the cap tube is soldered into the filter dryer. The filter dryer is where you're going to find your access port for the high side. So at this point right here is what we would consider our metering device. So in this instance here, our pressure would go from 124 to 14.4. We'll be checking the suction pressure off the compressor access port. It has a copper stubby off of it. We'll come through the cap tube to the evaporator. Okay, once we're in the evaporator, this will be located inside the box. At this point, it's absorbing all the heat and it's sending it back up to the compressor. So this is the ideal setup. So if we're looking for 34 box temperature, because we're on cap tube, the pressure shouldn't change for our suction. It should remain the same. So for our ambient 70, we'll add 30 Fahrenheit to that. That'll give us 100 Fahrenheit. 100 Fahrenheit will give us 124 PSI. So that's how we get our head pressure. Now our suction pressure is based off of a 34 box temperature. So if we have 34, that means our saturation temperature would be less 20. So 14 Fahrenheit. 14 Fahrenheit would equal 14.4. On a cap tube system, the suction pressure should remain the same. The cap tube's fixed. The dynamometer's set. The pressure should be the same. All right, so to get our suction pressure, we simply take our desired box temperature, so let's say 34 Fahrenheit. We're going to subtract 20 Fahrenheit from there. That's going to give us 14 Fahrenheit. 20 Fahrenheit is based on a 20 TD evaporator coil. Some of the walk-ins will be a 10 TD. Most of the regions are going to be is going to be a 20 TD. So we get 14 Fahrenheit. So we're going to go to our PT chart. Okay, 14 Fahrenheit equals 14.4. And that's what you should be getting. So to go back on that, let's say the desired box temperature is 36. So if we go 36 less 20, it's 16. Okay. So 16 Fahrenheit, if we go to our PT chart, is equal to 15.7. Okay, why this is important is because as we go higher up, higher on pressure, we can only get to we can only go so low in our box. So based on that, if we're getting 21.3 psi on our gauge, okay, 21.3 psi equals 24 Fahrenheit, and then so we start working backwards. So 24 plus 20 would give us 44. So based on a 21.3 PSI, the box could only get to 44 Fahrenheit. So we would know at that point, hey, we have an issue here. All right, so head pressure is the opposite. We add 30, we don't subtract. So first thing you wanna do is get your ambient temperature. This is gonna change all the time. So let's go just based on what you're gonna see the most, which would be 70 Fahrenheit. We're gonna add 30 Fahrenheit. And that should give us 100 Fahrenheit. So 100 Fahrenheit based on the PT chart will give us 124.2. Okay, this is very important for when you're charging stuff or just troubleshooting. Am I undercharged? Am I overcharged? Do I have restrictions? The ambient temperature is very important. So let's go based on an 80. Fahrenheit. Okay, that would give us 110. Okay, then we go to our PT chart to see 110 Fahrenheit saturation. Okay, that would give us 146.4. So let's go backwards here. If you get 158.4 PSI, and this is the way you're going to be troubleshooting it, because the first thing you do is put your gauges on, you're going to get 115 PSI. Okay, based on 115 PSI, we subtract that, we get 85. Okay, so if you're there and you're only getting, you're only getting 124 PSI. So if you're getting 124 PSI, which is the equivalent of a 70 ambient, but your ambient temperature is really 85, okay? We know that we're most likely have a restrictor or we're undercharged. All right, so in this example here, we have 60 box temperature, okay? Our low side gauge is reading 0 to 10 inches mercury, which is a pretty common error that we'll see, and the head pressure is 100. It should be 14.4, and 124 should be our pressures. So that means we have low suction and low head pressure. So in this instance, we would add refrigerant. Obviously, it's a critically charged system, so you don't want to exceed the charge amount. So if it's rated for 12 ounces, you don't have to go all the way up to 12 ounces. Go up to 8 or 9 ounces. Okay, if the pressures go up to what they should be, that means the unit is low on charge. At this point, we would reclaim the refrigerant, do a nitrogen test. You would repair the leak, vacuum to 500 microns. The system is critically charged, so we'll weigh it back in and we'll cycle the system. Now, these same pressures can also mean a second issue. So if you add the refrigerant and the pressures don't go to what they should be after adding the full charge, the system has a restriction. Okay, so if it's rated for, let's say, 12 ounces, you add in 10 ounces and that thing's staying in a vacuum, we have a restriction. So at this point, we'd remove the filter dryer and we'd leave the low side of the filter dryer capped. We'd blow out nitrogen through the suction port and see if there's adequate pressure coming out of the cap tube. So just say we have a system that's rated up to 150 PSI. We'd start at 150 PSI. We would blow it out. Now we're looking for 14 PSI. So we would drop it down to 14 PSI on the nitrogen and see if it flows. If it's barely flowing, that cap tube has got to be replaced. And if it's flowing like it should be at 14 PSI, that means you've blown out the restriction. All right, in this example, we have 20 suction and 175 head pressure. So we have high suction, high head pressure. So either the unit's overcharge or it has non-condensables in the system. So what you would do is reclaim the refrigerant, vacuum to 500 microns, and critically charge the system. And that should resolve the issue. All right, in this example, we have 55 suction and 90 head. So we have high suction and low head. So what's happening is the compressor's inefficient. Okay, it's not pumping the way it should. Or if you come and touch your hand on this line here, so you'll see this more if this pressure goes above 70. So if this pressure is above 70, you can actually come here and touch it, and you'll feel the line's hot. That means the actual valves have blown, and the high side is actually getting into the low side.